your brother and sister twins today getting baptized. This is Stevie DeSena, and Stevie, he has his family here. We're excited about that. Grandma and Grandpa over here, and we're so happy that he's received Christ and following the Lord and believer's baptism today. Stevie, have you asked Jesus Christ to come into your heart and to be your Savior? Stevie, upon your public profession of faith in Christ, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, buried in the likeness of his death. Raised in the likeness of his death. Jordan or Kobe Bryant who are able to take a team by themselves and win. And they've even found out in the recent years that one person by themselves can't win anymore. They're having to get not only one, but two and even three superstars that are going to work together so that their team can win, whether it be basketball or baseball or football. They need more than one person who's going to work together. If we're going to have a church where people are growing spiritually, we need church to grow. We need church to grow. I meet a lot of people nowadays in this time and age that we live in where the church is seemingly, it's almost looked down upon by some people, or looked as something that we have to do and we'll get it over with, but that's really not the purpose of church. Church is to help you become mature in the Christian life. And it takes other people working in my life to help me become what I need to be. I need to be able to come to church and I need to hear preaching from the Word of God. Isn't that right? I need truth that encourages me and strengthens me and helps me to grow. And if you go through a trial in your life, and so many people looking through the room here and notice that so many people have had great trials even this week. And Aaron, I know you and your family lost a grandbaby this week. Isn't that right? And very unexpectedly, just about a week old. Is that right? And just a tragedy in the life of their family. And we've had that happen a couple times in the past in our church, and it's just a trial. And we need church. We need church. We need people who can surround us with love. We need people who can encourage us when we're going through great trials. And even in the script here, it says we need somebody to speak the truth to us, even we don't want to hear it. Speak the truth, and speak it in love. But speak the truth, even maybe if we don't want to hear it, sometimes we need to hear what we don't want to hear because that's what we need to grow in the Christian life. Take a child and bring them up here on the stage this morning and bring up a little boy here, and we bring up an adult that's, their father, and bring them up here. I've done that before, but you bring a child and an adult, and the difference is, it's age, right? It's the maturity level. One is still growing. He's he weighs maybe 50 pounds and maybe a little guy. And then we got a dad that's over here. Maybe he's 6 feet tall. And maybe he's full grown and he's healthy and strong and educated and been through schools. And he's been, well, the difference is, it's maturity, right, everyone? But the difference between a child and an adult is a maturity level. Their body is matured, their mind is matured, and God wants us to grow. He intends each and every one of us. The Bible talks about us being a child or a baby. There's new believers that are called a baby, and they desire the sincere milk of the Word. You say, Pastor, I am mature. Praise the Lord. You are exactly who we need. We need you to help us, as the Scripture says, bring these babes in Christ to maturity. I've seen a number of awesome things this week. I saw a lady one of our ladies in our church.
Yeah.
Isn't that awesome? All right. One lady in our church working with a new believer had been at Parkway, a new Christian. I saw them working together. I thought, that's what it's about.
Amen.
That's what it's about. And there's people who need to grow, and there's people who have matured. And you know what? I'm going to say, have you ever seen a new Christian and they're so zealous and excited, and you're like, calm down a little bit. Come to church for 50 years, all right? And I feel that way. It's like, okay, calm down, think about what you're doing, stay with it long term. But there's people who are supposed to attend church. And I don't mind saying that. You say, Pastor, can we have church under a tree? Well, we can talk about that. You could. If we all went outside right under the tree, we could have church. I'm just saying. We could. Right? But I believe with all my heart, God calls us to be together as a church family and to grow in grace. God wants us to grow. You say, well, I've grown. Okay, if you've grown, all right, by the way, even the Apostle Paul talked about he was contending for the faith. Even the Apostle Paul talked about how he had to continue to strive for the mastery. Nobody, that means that nobody has arrived yet. I watched a little video. I told you I like sports, so give me a break, okay? I watched a video about Kobe Bryant and talked about how this man wanted to see Kobe Bryant practice. And he said, I want to see what you do on your own time. He said, all right, I'll meet you at 4 o'clock at a gymnasium. He's like, 4 o'clock today, I'll be over. He said, no, 4 a.m. And so the guy, he was an editor, he said, I'll meet you there. And he said, I decided I'm going to be there before Kobe Bryant. And so he got up real early and he got to the gym about 3:30 or 3:40 around in there. And he pulled up the gymnasium and he walked inside and noticed that the lights were already on. The door was unlocked and he saw Kobe Bryant. And Kobe Bryant was already been worked up into a sweat. He'd already been exercising since even before 4 o'clock. He told him to meet him at 4 o'clock. And what he was saying, the whole story was, the reason that he was such a great basketball player, the reason he was so good at it is because that he put so much effort, and even though he was the greatest in the world, he did not continue to quit improving.
Amen.
And as a Christian, I just say this, none of us are perfected. None of us have arrived yet, and each of us need to continue to grow in grace and strive to the mastery of our Christian life. We want to become what God wants us to be. Every Christian that's here, in here in this room, we need to grow. If you've been saved a long time, if you've been saved a week, hey, there's people in here who've been saved a few days, just a few days in church today. I'm excited about that. You grow in the Lord. You grow in the Lord. As we need spiritual grace. We've been given spiritual gifts, and the leaders that we have are a spiritual gift to us. If you look at me in, Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 12, now it says, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. I want you to notice that we have been given a spiritual goal. As the saints are perfected, the goals of the work of the ministry is accomplished, and the body of Christ is edified. Fulfillment of the Great Commission depends on the maturity of the saints. This is real preaching right here, right? I know this is like, you have to think about what we're saying here. I'll read it again. The fulfillment of the Great Commission depends upon the maturity of the saints. The greatness of the church is not determined by the people, how many people sit in the pews. The greatness of the church is dependent upon how many people we can reach from this church with the gospel of Christ.
Amen.
There's a lot of churches that have a lot of people, but they're not mature. We want to have a church that is mature.
Amen.